Hello everyone, my name is Anuj. I'm a second year MBBS student at GMC Nagpur, and thank you so much for clicking on this video. Well, today's topic is pretty interesting because I'm going to break the stereotype that reading gold standard books will not give you marks. I can guarantee you that if you put your heart and mind to it, you're going to get exceptionally good marks if you are in for a little bit effort. Anyways, let's start from the first topic. I want to question you one thing, is that if I want to bake a cake, there are two ovens which I have. One of them is at normal room temperature. The other one of them is preheated. So in which one of these two ovens will my cake be cooked faster and better? The obvious answer is the one which was preheated. So keep that thought in your mind. Okay, now let me just tell you how does cake and how does reading gold standard books come together. See, the thing is, the reason why we quit reading gold standard books in the first place is that first of all, we find that the information given is in a very complicated language. And if you ask a random person that, okay, so why did you stop reading, Harrison or Robbins? They will just answer you that the language was too complicated, man, I could not get it in my head. The second reason is that our human minds get overwhelmed by the amount of data that is given in that, so we stop reading those big books. Well, here's a very great solution to this idea, that is to preheat the oven. I mean to precondition your mind. So by preconditioning your mind, I actually mean that before diving into the gold standard books, have a base key, what are the things that you're going to be reading in that particular book. For example, if you're reading, something about antihypertensive drugs. If you don't know the mechanism of hypertension, then you are probably not going to fully understand how the antihypertensive drugs work. So the preconditioning over here is that knowing your physiology very well, and B, before starting the book itself, I want you guys to have a look at review books. So review books are those books which are used for NEET, PG and stuff like that. So they are designed to give you the maximum information in the least amount of time. So go through review books or go through lectures that may be online or offline, and you may interact with your friend with the same topic. So discussion, review, any of the sensory pathways which you can utilize that before actually going on and reading the big book itself. So what that will do is that it will just reduce the amount of friction that it takes to understand any particular topic, and the less friction you have, the longer you're gonna go without, you know, having burnout or without getting exhausted. So that was my first point, that keep your mind preconditioned. I can give you an example. Again, if you're reading antihypertensive, when you come on a drug like amlodipine, so the standard book is going to directly state like amlodipine is a negative inotrope and it will dilate the resistance vessels more than the capacitance vessels. And so what will happen is that you won't properly understand what is given until and unless you understand the basics key. Okay, so there are more calcium channels in the arterioles, and this is a calcium channel blocker, so it will open up the arterioles and relieve the pressure. So here's the thing, read review books before getting into the main standard textbook. Anyways, acquire some preconditioning before directly going into your standard textbooks. My next point is to read in a classification manner rather than a diffuse manner. Let's say you are reading something for the first time, like respiratory pathology. Then what will happen is that if you try to go and read it in one go, you will find like there are 35 to 40 diseases which are present and the things which can go wrong with the respiratory tract. But if you haven't classified it, you will pretty much forget what everything lies and where everything lies. So there won't be like a particular localization of information. And diffuse information is much easier to forget, whereas localized information is much harder to forget. So what I ask you to do is that next time, if you're reading the same thing, I want you to classify it like, okay, nasopharynx, there are like four diseases. In COPDs, there are like five diseases. And restrictive, there are four diseases. So the next time when I ask you, okay, so have you read about emphysema? So you quickly eliminate out other options like, okay, this is not a restrictive disease. This is not a tumor. This is not something else. This has something to do with the obstructive diseases. And then eventually what will happen is that you will arrive at the point and then you will be able to answer. And classification will not only ease out your answering process, but it will also ease out the way you are learning new things. And this is called as mapping the subject is very important. I can give you one more example. Say you're reading GI pathology for the first time and you have not mapped anything. So what will happen is that next day when I come and ask you, hey, have you read about Zollinger-Alcyon syndrome? And you'll be like, I think I probably read that somewhere yesterday. So to avoid that, what we can do is that we can classify every single disease. Okay, so there are few which can happen in the esophagus, which can happen in the colon, and which can happen in the small intestine. So that the next time when I ask you what is the Lingerhansen syndrome, you can like, okay, it's not the part of the esophagus, it's not the part of the intestines, it is definitely not the part of the liver. So I think it must lie somewhere in the stomach region, and by that you can completely arrive at the point that it's an hypergastrinoma. So yeah, that's the point, that classification makes life much more easier. Okay, so my third point is knowing what is important. So what I mean by that is that if you have like a big subject, then in that big subject there are a few topics which are very, very important, and we like to call this as high yield topics. So even in those high yield topics, there are subtopics which are much more high yield than other things. So if you're trying to read something from a gold standard book or a big book, what I want you to do is know what is important and read only those facts first which are important, and then go for the not so important points. How do you decide what is important and what is not? So let's say you are reading something like inflammatory bowel disease. If you look at Robbins, you will find that there is a huge chunk of that particular section just devoted to the pathogenesis of the disease. And it is very, very molecular. Like, okay, there is some mutation in this protein and some mutation in that protein, which leads to lymphocytes being autoreactive and stuff like that. What I feel like in the future, and even now, what will it benefit me knowing all the small genetic mutations and deletions? Will it actually help me and add in some value to my life? And my answer to that is not exactly. But if I know what the clinical presentation of the disease is, if I know what the symptoms are and how everything progresses, then that would not just benefit me right now, but also in the future. So obviously what I do is that the part which I feel is not so important to me, I just skip that part. And I don't skip it permanently, I read it from a different source which has a little less information. Okay, so the next point is, why are you reading this book in the first place? The answer is you want to have a deeper understanding, and maybe you just want to flex a little bit. So the deeper understanding concept is very important over here, because there's going to be time that these books will not really vibe with you. And I want you to know that it happens with everybody, and you don't have to give up when that thing happens. Okay, you just have to hold on to it and have the mindset that this is not memorization, this is understanding. And memorization is only for some technical things like names and like methodologies or terminologies. So that is the memorization part, but the understanding part is what you are here for. And no matter what efforts it takes, you just have to understand the stuff. And one of the practices that I do while reading this standard textbook is that, like I've always talked about, I write down the questions of the paragraphs that I'm reading. So what it does is that in the end, if I have this so many questions made from just one chapter, I look at the questions, and if I try to answer them, I will not just think about it, but actually form stronger memories. So writing questions and understanding the stuff more than memorization is something which you should definitely practice. Another thing which I found out was that if you're trying to read a page of a gold standard book, the different paragraphs which are given in the page are nothing but the explanation of the first line of the paragraph. I can give you an example. If you try to read like cirrhosis of liver, it will say that according to the gender, the cirrhosis can be happening in male or female, but females are more likely to have cirrhosis than males. You could just stop reading right over there and you can just move on to the next paragraph. But if you actually want to know what is the reason, read the paragraph given just below it. So my entire point over here is that whenever you're reading any gold standard textbook, the idea should be to read paragraph wise and not line by line wise. Because if you're going line by line, just reading a few points will take you like a lot of time. Instead, if you're going paragraph wise and skipping those things which are not exactly important and reading those which are, will save you a lot of time. And probably this is the best way to take out notes from any gold standard books. And many people struggle to take out the notes from very big books because they end up copying and making a revised edition of that book itself. So don't do that. If you want to take out notes, just use the first line of any paragraph, and I'm pretty sure most of the paragraphs will be covered by just one line. So yeah, that's how you take notes from a big any gold standard book. Read paragraph wise and not line by line wise. Okay, so now that you've read all the important things, you have mapped out everything, you have made notes, and you have done everything, what I want you to do is now go towards the things which you skipped or the things which you felt like they're not important, so you skipped them entirely. So for example, if you're reading like somatosensory pathway or maybe the motor pathway in the CNS, so you probably neglected Wallerian degeneration somewhere. Okay, so after reading this, after having this placed into your memory, go into the same book or some different book which you find easier and just read that topic once, because you never know from where the exam can give the question or what unusual presentation can the patient appear with. So yeah, that's the thing. Once you're done with the important topics, only then move on to the non-important topics. Otherwise, if you're reading gold standard books, the non-important topics are so much in number than the important topics that they're going to overwhelm you if you keep on reading everything. So first have a very nice base of important topics and then move forwards towards something which are less important. Okay, congratulations, you have just finished reading a gold standard book. Now what to do? See, in every chapter there will be some points which are facts and something which you just have to purely memorize. Those things you are bound to forget. They don't have a genuine explanation behind that, so you're gonna forget it. What I usually did in this context was that when I was reading physiology last year, after every chapter of Guyton, I made my notes and stuck them on the back page of that particular chapter using some sticky notes. So on that sticky notes, I used to write all the things which I found difficult in that topic. For example, in coagulation, I might have found out difficult, like what is von Willebrand's disease, but now I know it very well because I wrote it down then and there itself. So these are the things which you have to keep in mind, that at the end of the chapter, make a sticky notes column with the important points which you are likely to forget, and you may also summarize the different things which you want to as you wish. The next point is just accept that these books are big books and these are written by highly qualified people, and it won't be a miracle. Like, you will just go after this video and sit reading a book and you will complete the entire book in just like 1 month. So that's not possible. Maybe that is. I challenge you to do that and message me, showing me the proof, then I will feature you in my story. Anyways, the thing is, it will take time, and you have to accept the fact that it will take time. When I was initially reading Robbins, it gave me a huge sadness that this much stuff is left reading and I've studied only like this much. I was like, I study so much pathology and I've just completed this much portion. But now that I've done the entire thing, I just feel like, yeah, it happens to everybody, but we don't have to lose hope. We just have to like keep putting efforts, because if we lose a hope, then what's the point of any of this? So accept that it's going to take time and you will pull through if you stick with your goals and aims. My next and the last important point is that if you feel like you are not being benefited by reading such big books, sleeve them. One of my professors told me that the best book is different for every student, and a student should only use that book which helps him understand an information very better and also retain that information and reciprocate it. So with that, I would like to conclude this video. Anyways, one special announcement is that I am thinking of starting a new series which is a little personal to my life, and I'll probably be revealing that on Instagram. So go follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. And thank you so much for 50,000 subscribers. I mean, like a few videos ago we were at 10,000. So yeah, huge, pretty good growth. Thank you so much to every single one of you who has ever interacted with my video. Thank you for all of that. And thank you so much for watching this video. And I hope that this video helped you out in some way or the other. And if it did, please hit that thumbs up button. It gives me so much motivation to produce new videos. So yeah, and please subscribe to my channel. It not just makes up for all the effort that goes into making these videos apart from the daily schedule that I'm into. So yeah, it would mean a lot if you'd subscribe. So thank you for that. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. And if you do complete that book in about a month, with evidence, I'll feature you. Until next time, I'll see you soon.